to the 16-yard line. Out there, set, ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
Well, I wish his staff luck as they try to find positives about this performance by their offense as we move through the early part of the fourth quarter. That sack, the latest example.
And Wentz will not be able to get rid of it. He's taken down for a safety. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over. Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Tua going to throw. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Bobby McCain, and the Commanders are going to take over at their own 2-yard line. They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. But with this advantage, this defense knew the passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a way to cap things off, huh? Because I think this is part of the game within the game. They see the scoreboard.
And he's got his tight end, Gesicki, in the end zone. Touchdown, Dolphins. A great effort there. Beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Dolphins add another 6 points to what's going to be a blowout victory. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And this one is a while to go as he gets add on to that big lead. And this is going to be returned from near the end zone. And no chance to get away as they get him down at about the 17-yard line. Out there, set, ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be And now here's another interception. Picked up by Javon Holland. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense. And certainly a signal caller, Charles, that's thrown all these interceptions. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back for the score.
In the postgame highlights to show this group of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Out there, set, ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense.
And my goodness, another interception. picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. Another great play defensively. They've been sharp on both sides of the ball, Charles, but that interception means that this defense could very well keep them down to single digits on the scoreboard in this game.
And that's certainly something to smile about, isn't it, partner, if you're on defense? Because your goal every game is to pitch a shutout, but you and I both know that's pretty unrealistic. But to hold a team below double figures in a game, in an NFL game, that's certainly something to take pride in.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, at this juncture, CD, you normally see teams pack in the passing game. They've got the huge lead. Not them, though. They're still taking their shots.
I remember reading in past history, there was a college football coach in the Hall of Fame whose nickname was Close the Gates of Mercy. Well, he wasn't really big on that. He was big on going ahead and scoring. He's got reincarnated right here. We're watching it in front of us.
Ready? They'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he is in. Touchdown, Miami. Alec Ingold taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Dolphins have widened the gap now to 50 points. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go with this one. Exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track. And now here's another interception. Picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. Yet another mistake after the interception there. Gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, and now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Cameron Curl. And the Commanders are going to have it here just past the 25. Well, they're not making it easy on themselves here down the stretch. Two picks now in the fourth quarter trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people who are really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Wentz will try again on second down. And his throw is incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. To throw, it's Wentz. Completes it to Samuel. And he's going to have a Commander's first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Wentz to throw again. Over the middle, he gets it to Gibson. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down. On play action, it's Wentz. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, and that could have been trouble. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter. What has been a one-sided affair. The good news, they kept the ball. Bad news, it's third and long. Now Wentz. And my goodness, another interception. picked off by Xavien Howard.
Well, partner, I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Jamin Davis. And the Commanders are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line.
Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. Wentz going to throw. Able to connect with Dotson. And he's going to have a Commander's first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Throwing on first is Wentz. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well.
And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Bradley Chubb, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon. Wentz and the Commanders staring down a third and long now. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. For this defense, CeeDee, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this one.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there? You know, they have the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
Here's Mostert,
and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes, and that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And this one's moving on. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. First down, Wentz. Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one deep. And this one is incomplete.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
Lefty, lefty.
Now we've got whistles here before the snap, and I believe this is going to be on Washington. one final try now for Wentz. In trouble, and he's taken down. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training. I just scraped it off the top, put it on the roll, on the curve, on the block. It was already sold, I don't work by 10 o'clock. Too deep in the streets, felt it.